Well, I could tell you about, I've been Flatwoods ever since 1920.
1920?
Mm-hmm.
Were you born here?
No, I was born in the country, but I was 3 years old when I tell you. I'm 84 now.
Really?
No woman.
Okay. What were some of the, when you first came here, what were some of the major families that were, had farms here or something like that? That the dominated Flatwoods that first started it?
About Flatwoods?
Uh-huh.
Well, we didn't, there was no electric, there was no gas. We had to burn coal and lamps and coal, burn coal and stove. That's a heat we had.
Mm-hmm.
And we had, and the roads were so bad, they didn't have no roads at all, and they had even horses and wagons, that wagons would get stuck up, they'd have to push them out. The roads were so bad, and here in the U.S. Russell.
Okay, and you know your family, the Clarks, were they one of the families that started Flatwoods?
Huh?
Were the Clarks some of the families that started Flatwoods?
I think you're very good.
Mr. Hanner said us that there were different families that owned large farms here.
Oh, we did in the country, back out in the country, but we don't care in fact. Didn't have very much in Flatwoods. We had, my dad had 3 acres of ground, but he sold it off when he died.
Uh-huh. What were some of the families that did? Lots of land.
Our people I know in Flatwoods are
their
own family.
Huh?
My family or
others.
Huh?
Other people.
Mm-hmm. Well, there are Riggs was here when they moved here. There's Riggs and
Bailey. Were the Baileys here?
Huh?
Were the Baileys?
Baileys?
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Baileys. Were there any other ones?
And Gillies. Oh, they was several people here, but there wasn't really any houses in Flatwoods. And Commons.
Okay.
I expect you to know Kate Common, don't you?
I think so. I'm not sure.
She's a teacher.
She's a teacher? Yeah, I think I do.
I don't know what she don't say.
Mm-hmm.
But that was her grandmother and grandpa, you know.
Okay.
And how many names do you want? Oh, different names?
Well, it doesn't matter. You know, just how many names you can.
And the, well, that was, well, the Williams, they was here too, the Williams.
Okay.
And Rayburns.
Rayburns. Okay. And, you know, what was the main recreational thing? Did you guys go to the movies or?
They didn't have nothing here.
Nothing.
I went first of them. Now you might think that as old as I am, you might think. I went to Keith Hammond Theater in Huntington,
mm-hmm.
and seen the first talking picture I ever seen.
Really?
It's a talking picture. That's all signed. Yeah. That was in 1928.
Okay.
And but that ain't about Flatwoods, though, is it? It's not me, but, well, about the road, I told you about the road, though.
Mm-hmm.
Now, they fixed the road from, a hard road from Russell, or from West Russell, to out here to the corner where the city building is, in 1922.
In 22? Okay, what was, and like, what were the houses like? Were don't know, were they the bigger kind or they were just the smaller type?
The houses, what kind of houses they had? Well, a lot of them had four-room houses, and some had five. They had big families, too. Mm-hmm. They all just sat in the same bed. And I tell you somebody else that now got you, because they share four rooms here, is a pal.
The what?
Pal. Pal that you're in the middle.
Mm-hmm.
Well, there's a lot of people you can, you just don't think of them all at once.
Mm-hmm.
But, and then, and my dad, there wasn't no, see, electrical gas, you know, and my dad sold ice in Flatwoods here for 12 years. And he'd go around in the spring of the year and give these cards out. I don't know if you've ever seen them. You put in the winder, and what, 25 pound or 50 pound or 100 pound. And so people put in the winder, and he, if they wanted ice, they'd put whichever one in the winder so he'd take them ice.
Hmm.
And he sold for 12 years.
Really?
And he had just a horse and express.
Really?
And he'd make the round. He'd go from around every morning, get up and leave about 7 o'clock. And he'd get through with about 3.
Oh, that'd come from me imagining horses and buggies.
Yeah.
What were some of, like, the businesses, like general stores or...
In Flatwood?
Yeah.
Well, Bert Collins had a grocery store.
Do you remember the name of it?
Bert Collins' store, he just had a general store.
Okay. What it did, my mom told me that that the pig pack up here, the Pennington's, they used to have a different building than the one now.
Oh yes, you used to have an old building. I traded with them for years. It used to be, they bought from Bert Collins, you know, but yeah, that was it.
Really?
Was it,
I said something about a big pink building or something.
Uh-huh.
Mom said something about a big pink building that used to be near that Flatwoods department store.
I don't know. What was your mother's name?
Pat Rose.
Huh?
Patricia Rose.
Rose, I don't guess I know her.
Oh yeah, her mom and dad are from Westwood.
They used to have two churches.
What were the name?
When we moved to the church, they had the Methodist church here in Flatwood.
Where was it at?
It was up here where the city building is then. It's been tore down, the new one's been built. And then they had the Pentecostal church, it was a little old building.
Mm-hmm.
And they tore it down. This was then when we moved here, this little old building.
Where was it at?
It was right by Fort, do you know what Pentecostal church is now? Right across there from
the
dress shop.
Yeah, it's up there.
Yeah, right there, not far from the city building.
Okay.
On Belfont Road.
Just the one they just added on to?
On Belfont Road.
Okay. If I think of this question. We forgot our questions and we forgot what we wanted to ask you.
Okay, can you remember the racetrack down in Raceland?
The what?
The racetrack down
in Raceland. Yeah, I went there.
Really? Was that it? Did you have to go there for recreation stuff?
What did you say?
Did you guys go down there? Did all you and your friends go down there?
They have 3 days for the women, and when they have 3 days, Miss Common, she didn't bet, but she went, and she got, and her, she had a son at bed, and he let me go sit with his mother, and took me down there with them. Mm. And that was a long, that was been 1926 or something like that.
What time did they? Do you know when they don't have it anymore? Do you know when they demolished it or didn't have it anymore?
The racetrack.
When I tore down.
Huh?
You know when I tore down?
I think you're very good.
Okay, well, is it, do you know when they closed it up? Closed it racetrack?
Well, they didn't, you have over a year or two. I don't know, something happened, people didn't want it long, but at the racetrack or something.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know why.
Do they get a lot of big crowds? And
oh, yes, it's awful crowd. I love to go, I just go just to be there and see the rat and horses, and then they had the band, played the band. I was younger then, I could go, I loved to go.
They had bands?
Yeah, they had bands to play. I don't want bands to play, but they had bands playing. It might have been wrestling band or somebody. I don't know what band was. They had a band, they had bands played there, I know. And oh, they played so good.
Really?
Mm-hmm. I enjoyed it.
What kind of schools do they have here? What schools do they have?
School.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I'll tell you when we moved here, I'm going to tell you this. Yes. Then this, right up here, you know, Lynn, this schoolhouse, that was at school. Yeah. Well, right there, the end of it, that wasn't there. And he had a building up there. It had one room downstairs and one room upstairs. And it faded yellow when we moved here. They built a little, had blocks, a little block building for little to be in on the back of that right then. And that was 1920. And then they commenced building this other.
Was it, you know, that one in the back of it, the back of Evans, that gray building?
Yeah.
Was that it?
It's there yet, then.
No, I think they tore it down.
They tore it down.
They tore it down on the block building?
Mm-hmm. Just a few years ago.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Now, when we moved to Flatwoods in 1920, we moved to Flatwoods, the name of it was Advance, Kentucky.
Amen.
The post service was.
1920.
The
name of it was Chief at one time.
Yeah, we had a vine preacher in the Methodist Church, and his name was Chief. And they named the post office after him. And he was a blind man. He had a girl. He had a pony and a two-wheel cart. And his daughter, Edith, took him around to visit people in that two-wheel cart. The road was bad, so they didn't have cars then.
He was blind?
Yeah, he's blind. He preached in our church.
Mm. Do you remember his name?
I think it's John Chief. I think his name's Chief.
Okay. And what about McDowell? You know, the school over there.
Yeah. That was named after Mr. McDowell. He was a professor at the school for years. Mr. McDowell was. He's a good man.
What time was it already built when you came here?
Huh?
Was it already built when you came here?
Oh, no.
No?
No, they didn't build that. This all they had up here when I come here. That was built, I don't know when it was.
Was it built around the 1940s or
so? I can't just remember when that was built.
Mm-hmm.
I had children to go there to school. I mean, nieces to go there to school. I don't know.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, but it ain't been there too long, and then they left that high school, that school over there at Russell.
When did they build, somebody told me about, you know, there's that school over down by Wheeler Hill, and it used to be West Russell.
There used to be one over there, but I don't know much about it.
Really?
No, I don't know. They was, but they didn't, it was there for a while, I don't know. And they quit going there and went for us.
Do you know when it closed down or anything?
Huh?
Do you know when it closed down or anything?
Well, it's been several years. I can't remember That because I never did try to keep up with that school. I didn't, none of my folks went there to school and I didn't know.
Mm-hmm.
And all my folks, my nephews and nieces, they didn't have them buses to take them to school. They had to walk to Russell, into Russell, to school. There's an Oak Cliff End, do you know Oak Cliff End?
Mm-hmm.
Did you know him?
What's his name?
Oakley Fannin. Him and Harold Fannin and Lonjo Fannin and Fenton Fannin all had to walk across the school. They had to walk in there to get their education. They didn't have no buses to take anybody. And if they went on, they did have that, but with us a while, and they, once in a while they'd go on that, but they just didn't have no buses.
Mm-hmm.
They had to walk.
And they had to walk down to the more central school, is that right?
Yeah, in Russell. But,
mm-hmm.
To get their education, that's what they were doing.
Let's see, what else did we have in the paper?
And something else I was going to tell you about what it was then. We got it all mixed up together, ain't it?
Mm-hmm.
You can straighten it out, though, can't you?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. We'll figure it out. Let's see.
Well, that should
have been.
We forgot our questions.
Well, I was going to tell you about that Tim Andrews in particular. He's your teacher.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
He's my niece's son.
Mm-hmm.
Tim is. Tim used to come here a long time towards us. And now his daddy was named Walter Clarke. Tim's daddy's name, and he got his back broke up here. He's a carpenter working in the schoolhouse up here, and names.
Mm-hmm.
Got his back broke and he died. He died back a couple of weeks after. But that was before he, his mother was just a little girl then.
Mm-hmm.
And, Tim's a good boy. I think Tim's a good boy.
Yeah, he is.
I think he's good, don't you?
Uh-huh. He's a good teacher.
Uh-huh.
I've had him 2 years.
Thank you, man. I think he's pretty good, too. He was a little boy. He'd come over here, and when he was going with his wife, he'd bring her here sometimes, and then he'd come a time between him and John Lynn come together. He is a good friend, John Lynn.
Mm-hmm. Let's see. How long have you lived here? About
64
years?
Here?
Uh-huh.
I come here
in
1928.
You said before. 4 years. Yes. And you said that back then they used horse and buggy for travel?
Huh?
You said back, when you first moved here, they used horse and buggy for travel? Like you said, the minister went on a horse and buggy.
I can't hear. I'm hard eared. I'm sorry.
Oh, that's okay. You said that when you first moved here, did they use horse and buggy?
Oh, yes. Everybody had a horse and buggy, or horses and wagons.
Mm-hmm.
And there wasn't but two people had
automobiles.
There were two or three. Charlie Conlon had a car, and Will Riggs had a car. Those boys, he wasn't unmarried. And Earl Chin had a car. There's three cars I know of in 1920 years. And I know that Charlie got this car, and everybody said, they lived in a log house up there, And everybody said, what do you think about him getting a car and leaving in a log house? the young folks thought about that.
When did the horse and buggy die out? Like,
there's
just all cars?
Well, everybody got to get in cars, and they didn't have so many, buggies very much. And the horses. But after we come to Flatwoods, we had a horse and buggy, and my dad went around fast, but when he come in at evening sometimes, he had express a bigger way, but well, he all nice then. But the buggy, he hit the horse up for me, and I'd drive it and go out in the country sometime, drive a horse and buggy. Yeah.
Where would you go out to the country? Out there?
We went out to Danville, Kentucky. That's where we was raised.
Really?
Danville. You know where Danville is there? Well, it wasn't where Danville school is, but it's there, more than that, down there where the church and everything is there.
Do you think
there's
another question? Oh,
Do
Caroline, well, you go over there about our guide and go, I don't know just exactly how you're going to get there, but you go across that hill, you know, go toward what you call our guide and go up that way to Caroline, you know, there's furnace. And then there's a old steam furnace. Down the old steam, there was one, the rocks there, but, you know, I don't know what was there. The cinders are still there.
Okay, and what were
some of the main
occupations?
Like,
what did most of the men?
Uh-huh.
What did most of the men do for a living or
work? Well, you know, on our place, they farmed, they raised corn and beans and all kind of garden stuff. Big field of corn, and then they'd cut down trees and have sawmills and saw up their lumber and then they would chop up the wood and they'd make cord, they'd call it cordwood, and they'd fix that all together. And we had two of them, two of these things, coal pits. They'd set the fire and let it go so many, I don't know how many, whether a month or 2 months or how long, but it smoked and it made charcoal. You know charcoal like we burn that up? Mm-hmm. Well, we had that charcoal. And when it burnt, we'd have a man come. You have to wash it day and night so it wouldn't get a fire. Just had smoke all night, you know, burn on the inside. And it burned. And then when, of course, I was little, I still live for nothing. I don't guess I'm old enough to go to school, but I remember this. And they'd had men to come there and stay at work of the night. They have to watch it just like they watched around and see when they get caught. And then when it got done, they'd sell that over to our guy. They had an EK train. You know, old EK train over to our guide. And they, my dad, they had a big coal wagon and they had, and then we had oxen. They had oxen and they had yokes on them, they'd pull them. But four oxen would pull this over there to our guide, and they'd put it on the train and sell that, and that got the money out of that, you know. And then we'd raise wheat. We'd raise that, and in place of, he'd take that to Greenland and trade it for fairy flour. I remember them trading what wheat he had. He traded down to Greenland for 2 barrels of flour. And they had the magic. Nobody did nothing. The magic. Mm-hmm. Then we had so many hogs. We always killed. Well, sometimes we killed 5 hogs in a whole year. We had to get 7, but we always killed as much as 5. And we'd have all of our meat, you know, hams and shoulders, and, you know, all that together.
Okay, and what
and people was awful pretty that day and time. They wasn't like they are now. They don't, nobody give nobody nothing. That's that. But when they kill hogs or anything like that, rich and their neighbors, messing these different ones all around there. Some of them live pretty far away. But we give meat, and when they kill hogs, they send nothing. First news when they came. People don't do that anymore like that.
Yeah. Did some of the men work in coal mines or on the train?
We had a coal bank on our farm. And we had a coal bank, but none of my family didn't go back in it. We always hired a man to dig the coal out for us, you know.
Mm-hmm.
We always had all the coal we burnt. We had a good coal bank. Emerson Master always, because he's been dead for years, he always dug a coal for us, and we had thaw. We'd have plenty of coal in, and we'd have to cook the coal. You know, we had meat. On the way, sometimes we'd cook the wood. We got a new stove one time, and my mother said she didn't want to cook, burned up the coal. She cook, burn wood. They got to chop on wood. She took the wood, and that's for a long time.
Mm-hmm. Did some of the men work on, like boats on the river, or
an
Anco there?
The what?
Did they work in, like on the railroad? Some of the men
that was? Well, they actually got married. Some of my brothers got married, and they were to wrestling racing, and they worked on there, but the ones that lived out there, they just farmed. Just farmed and then things out there.
Mm-hmm.
And then every Wednesday, my dad would go to town, and he'd take beans and everything we raised so we could get that ready. And then we sold milk and butter. Sold butter, 40 pounds of butter. We had 9 cows. And my mother molded 40 pounds of butter. That's when we were on the farm, it wasn't Flatwoods, that was the farm.
Do you know when Arnco was first started?
No, I don't remember when it first started. I don't know what that was.
Mm-hmm.
Youngest brother, worked on Arnco, moved here. He worked at Arnco, he's dead now. And then I know a lot of people worked on it, but I don't know much about when it started. It's been there a long time.
Mm-hmm. What about, do you know that down there by the Methodist Church, that the new built Methodist Church?
Yeah.
$1? Were they here when you moved here? $1?
No, they weren't here. They weren't here.
Do you know when it started?
Who?
Do you know when $1 started?
They've been going a long time. It's been there a long time.
No, so they've been there for
a but I don't remember just how long. I didn't trade the barn dollars.
Really? Yeah.
I traded pickpacks. I traded cows as long as they stayed in. Then pigs got in, and I traded the thing and traded the thing.
Mm-hmm. Were there any banks here?
Banks?
You know,
when they built no, there wasn't nothing. Russell makes some fun in Russell.
You know when they started Flatwoods?
Huh?
Do you know when any of the banks in Flatwoods started?